Hello students, welcome to Plus One Political Science class. Today I will continue the discussion of lesson 3, The Origin of the State. This chapter has three theories of the origin of the state: divine origin theory, social contract theory, and evolutionary theory. Already I have discussed with you divine origin theory and social contract theory. The objectives of today's class are evolutionary theory of the origin of the state, its meaning, factors that played a part in the evolution of the state, main stages in the evolution of the state, and rise of nation state. Before the discussion of today's topic, I would like to discuss the keywords with you. First word is evolutionary, means related to gradual development of something. Kinship, blood relationship. Tribe, traditional society with common culture. Clan, a close-knit group of interrelated families. Feudalism, social system in medieval Europe in which nobility held land from the crown. Now I will discuss today's topic, that is evolutionary theory of the origin of the state. It is from page 70 till 78. This theory advocates that state has originated through a natural process of historical evolution. It had its birth in such a natural way that people came to realize its presence only after they became its members or citizens. We cannot fix an exact historical date when the state had its origin, but it's assured that state originated in times very ancient and developed into its modern form, that is the nation state, in the modern period of history. Several factors played a part in its origin and evolution, but there are some key factors that I would like to discuss with you. The first factor is natural human social instinct. We all know that the basic factor of man is the man is a social animal, and his necessities compel him to live in society, and this is how he enters into social relationship. The society needs peace, order, and protection, and for serving these needs, the state came into existence in natural way. So this is natural human social instinct point. Hope you are clear about this point. Now I will discuss the next point, that is kinship and family. Kinship acted as the strongest bond of unity. Reproduction, instinct, and blood relationship gave birth to the family. The family grew into clan, and clan grew into a tribe. And so there became the head of tribe, and it forced to settle on the piece of territory, and all this gave birth to the state. So it was a natural birth of the state. Hope you are clear about this point also. Now the third factor of the birth is religion. Now I will discuss about the point religion as a factor of the origin of the state. Along with kinship, religion also acted as a factor of birth of the state. Common religion came to be symbol of the common kinship. It started with worship of nature and worship of ancestors, and later religion became a family feature to lessen the fear of evil spirits. Later, the head of the tribe used it to secure his authority and orders. So religion also helped in the formation of the state. Students, here I would like to tell you that factor of force also played a part in the emergence of state. So the next point is wars and conflicts. Tribal wars of ancient times needed the unity of tribe under its leader. Without a powerful leader, it was difficult to win a tribal war. Either the tribal leader proclaimed himself to be the king of the tribe, or the tribe accepted him as a king. This type of arrangement evolved naturally and helped the process of the emergence of state. So, factor of force also played an important part in the formation of state. The next factor is economic factor. Now I will discuss the economic factor. Increase in the needs of man resulted in the institution of private property of families. Later, the social relations became very complex. So, need was felt for organized authority capable of protecting the life, property, and social relations. This related and created the environment in favor of emergence of state. Even today also, you see, it's one of the major responsibility of the government to provide protection to the life and property of the people and maintain law and order. You know, these days, as corona lockdown is going on, it is the responsibility of our Prime Minister to maintain law and order in the country. He keeps on having the video conference with the chief ministers of various states and talks about the extension of lockdown. So it's his responsibility. Recently, he decided about starting the railways. How to start and how to maintain law and order, it's his responsibility. So this is the state and government's responsibility. Hope this point is clear. Now I will discuss the next point, that is political consciousness and the need for the political order or power. The ever-growing complex social relations compelled the human need and the mind to ensure a peaceful social order. Further, the necessity of internal and external security favored the need of organized institution. This is how the government and state appeared on the scene. So, it's a final factor which led to the birth of the state. Thus, the state has been the result of several factors which I've discussed that helped in the process of emergence of state. Evolutionary origin of the state can also be seen from the stages in which it has evolved after its birth, like the tribal state, the Greek city-state, the Roman Empire, the Holy Roman Empire, the feudal state, and the nation state. Now, I will discuss the topic, the rise of nation state. I will discuss this point in detail with you. Under the impact of Renaissance and the Reformation, there was birth of absolute monarchies, and the birth of strong monarchies led to the emergence of nation states and in various parts of Europe. Later, the concept of sovereignty also got recognition. Sovereign states maintained relations with each other nation to secure their national interest. In the era of imperialism, even the use of power of state for dominating other states came to be recognized as a right of the state. Later, nationalism came to be as a key element in the emergence and working of the nation-state system in the international relations. Finally, the nation-states also of the world came to be the recognized as equal sovereign states irrespective of their size, population, capabilities, military or economic resources. Students, this gave equal recognition to all the nation states in the present world. All nation states have recognition by international organizations like United Nations, and all the matters of disputes between the nations are solved by this organization because it's international organization. Students, this finishes my topic, that is the evolutionary theory of the origin of the state, and this also finishes your lesson 3, the origin of the state. You will revise this chapter and watch the videos again and solve the SNAP homework questions. See you next time. Till then, goodbye and thank you.